Hello, children. How are you all? So today the topic is the sun. And today we will study about some basic information. So let's begin. So my dear students, after going through this topic, you will be able to categorize the sun as a star. Name the gases present in the sun. Explain the reason for the heat and light of the sun. Tell the distance between the earth and the sun. Tell the diameter of the sun. And name the atmosphere of the sun. Now, let us study about the sun. This, my students, is the closest picture ever taken of the surface of the sun. Let's read about some of the information. Sun is a star. Yes, like the thousands of stars you see daily in night in the sky. The sun is also a star. It is at a distance of about 150 million kilometers from the earth. It is a huge ball of hot burning gases. The sun is made of mainly hydrogen and one more gas called as helium. At the center of the sun, that is, in the core of the sun, the hydrogen gas is continually changing into helium, releasing huge amount of heat and light energy. This energy released by the sun is known as solar energy. The spherical sun has a diameter of about 13,92,000 kilometers. It is so big that a million of Earths can fit into it. But still, as compared to the other stars of the universe, the sun is a dwarf star. Other stars are much, much bigger than the sun. Solar energy is the most important form of energy on the earth. Using solar energy, the plants prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis. And if plants are there, we are there. The atmosphere of the sun is called the corona. The sun is the center of the solar system, which comprises the sun itself and other celestial bodies. Celestial means heavenly bodies that revolve around it, such as planets and their satellites, comets, asteroids, and dwarf planets. So, children, let's recap. The sun is a star, though a smaller one as compared to the other stars of the universe. The energy of the sun is due to the conversion of hydrogen into helium, which releases a large amount of heat and light. The sun is so big that a million of Earths can fit into it. And the sun is the principal source of energy on the earth. That's all for today, my dear students. Thank you. Happy learning. Bye-bye.